मीटिंग टुडे कॉन्सेप्ट इज टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड लेवल्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग, टुडे कॉन्सेप्ट टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. सो वेन एवर यू आर वर्किंग विथ एनी सॉफ्टवेयर कंपनी मैक्स वी कैन परफॉर्म 18 टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस 18 टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग्स. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इज टाइप ऑफ टेस्टिंग. टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग टुडे कॉन्सेप्ट टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. There are 18 types of testing. Whenever you are working with any software company, max we can perform 18 types of testing. Today we will discuss some type of testing. So one is first one, build acceptance testing. Build acceptance testing. Simply we can say BAT. Or we can say build verification testing. Simply we can say BVT. Or sanity testing. Or smoke testing. There are four types of there are 18 types of testing. So first type of testing, very very important type of testing, that is build acceptance testing or build verification testing or sanity testing or smoke testing. What is build acceptance testing? We will discuss now. Very very important testing. Whenever you are working with any software company, first of all we will perform this type of testing. This is the initial testing, initial or first type of testing, that is build acceptance testing. So for example, developers developed volume 1 volume 2 result. They developed three button, three functionalities, and they are sending to testing department. So we will accept or reject this type of build. So we will reject this type of build. There is no chance to perform any type of testing. So wherever you go, after getting the software, after getting the project, each and every software company, they will divide the whole project into some modules. So that is called high level designing. Each and every module divided into some sub modules. So that is called low level designing. Each and every submodule divide build wise and they will develop and they will sending to testing department. So this build is properly or not, we will do testing. This build is properly further detailed testing. If you want to do testing, this build is properly or not, we will do testing. That's why that is called build acceptance testing or build verification testing or sanity testing or smoke testing. So this build is properly or not, we are doing testing. So they are sending volume 1, volume 2, result functionality. Three functionalities they developed and they are sending to testing department. Then we are doing testing. This build is properly or not. This build is properly or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called build acceptance testing or build verification. So build acceptance testing, we will accept or reject. Build verification testing, this build is properly or not, we are doing testing. So our sanity testing or smoke testing. This build is properly or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called build acceptance testing or build verification testing or sanity testing. That build is properly or not. So if they send like this, we will reject this this type of build. Why? Because we can take 10 in the place of value 1. We can take 20 in the place of value 2. Simply we can sit. We can't do any chance. We can't do any testing. There is no chance to perform any type of testing. Simply we will reject this type of build. So this type of testing is called build acceptance testing. If they send like add button also, if they send like add button also, so we will accept this build. Add button is properly working or not, we will check later. But they are sending, this is the complete build. This is complete build. So add button is properly working or not, we will check later. We will test later. But this build is properly or not. Is there any chance to perform any type of testing? We will do testing. So that's why that is called build acceptance testing. Once if you accept the build, there is no chance to reject the build once again. So once if you accept the build, compulsory we should test, or otherwise we can't say we can't reject the build. So ఎందుకంటే ఒక్కసారి యాక్సెప్ట్ చేసినప్పుడు అప్పుడు మీరు నిద్రపోతున్నారా అని అడుగుతారు అన్నమాట. సో వన్స్ యాక్సెప్ట్ ద బిల్ కంపల్సరీ వీ నీడ్ టు టెస్ట్. సో విన్ అవర్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు సిటిసి సికింద్రాబాద్, ఐ ఆర్డర్డ్ 100 కంప్యూటర్స్, దే ఆర్ డెలివరింగ్ 100 కంప్యూటర్స్. నవ్ ఐఎమ్ కీపింగ్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఓన్లీ ఆన్ 100 కంప్యూటర్స్ ఆర్ డెలివరింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్. సో ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ కంప్యూటర్ ఈజ్ వర్కింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఐ విల్ చెక్ లేటర్. I will check later. Now I am concentrating on only quantity. 100 computers are delivering or not, I am concentrating. Just like here also, whenever developers develop the build, they are sending to testing department, then this build is properly or not, further detailed testing. If you want to do different types of testings, so this build is properly or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called build acceptance testing or build verification testing or sanity testing or smoke testing. Build acceptance testing or build verification testing or sanity testing or smoke testing. This build is properly or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called build acceptance testing or build verification testing or sanity testing or smoke testing. So build is properly or not, we are doing testing. So that's the reason we are calling build acceptance testing. We will accept or reject. Build verification testing, we are verifying the build. This build is properly or not. And sanity testing or smoke testing. So in USA, some companies they are calling before releasing the build, developers also will do same type of testing. So that's why that is called smoke testing they are calling. So just you should remember, before releasing the build, developers also will do testing based on the customer requirements. This build is properly developed or not, they will do testing. Or this build is properly or not, they will do testing. So that's why that is called smoke testing. In USA, some companies they are calling. So in India, all the companies they are saying before after releasing the build, this build is properly or not, testers will do testing. This build is properly or not, properly further detailed testing. This build is properly for further detailed testing. This build is properly or not, they will do testing. So that's why that is called build acceptance testing or build verification testing or sanity testing or smoke testing. So this is the first type of testing. This is the initial testing. First testing we will do, if it is any application, any project, we will do first type of testing is build acceptance testing. Build acceptance testing, there is meaning build accept or reject. Build verification testing, this build is properly or not, we are verifying the build. Sanity testing or smoke testing. Next type of testing, regression testing. Next type of testing, regression testing. Regression testing means already tested functionality, again and again we will do testing. That's why that is called regression testing. Already tested functionality, again and again we will do testing. That's why that is called regression test. Already tested functionality, why we need to do again and again? So this regression testing we will do in two scenarios. Regression testing we will do in two scenarios. First scenario, I will explain you. First scenario, this is the application. Developer, they are sending to testing department. First situation. So regression testing we will do in two scenarios. First situation, what is regression testing? Already tested functionality, again and again we will do testing. That's why that is called regression testing. I am taking 10 in the place of value 1. I am taking 20 in the place of value 2. I am clicking on add button. It is showing 40. It is showing 30. Add button is properly working. I am clicking on subtraction. It is showing minus 10. Yes, working. I'm clicking on multiplication, it is showing 300, 200, so it is working. I'm clicking on do button, it is showing 0.6. Actually, it need to show 0.5, but now it is showing 0.6. So then we will raise the defect to developers. Then developers will rectify the problem, and once again they are sending to testing department. Now, can we test the only div functionality or add or sub mul functionalities also? Only add, sub, mul, already tested functionalities, all are working fine. So only div functionality is not working. I raised the defect to developers. So developers rectified and they are sending to testing department. Now can we test the all the functionalities? Only one functionality.
We need to check total functionality once.
Why?
Because already add functionality.
Already add functionality, sub functionality, mul functionality, already tested functionalities. Why we need?
Again they are adding the again they are adding that some developers related to division. It is affected to the remaining add, sub, or multiply. We need to check once again.
Yes, whenever you are doing any changes to that application or any button, any functionality, other functionalities may be reflect or affect. That's the reason once again we need to test the all the functionalities, not only defect functionality, already tested functionalities also. Once again we will do testing, so that's why that is called regression testing scenario one. Not only defect functionality, already tested functionalities also. Once again we will do testing, that's why that is called regression testing. Regression testing we will do in two scenarios: already tested functionality, again and again we will do testing, that's why that is called regression testing. This regression testing we will do in two scenarios. First scenario, whenever you are raising the defect to developers, the developers will rectify the problem and they will send it to testing department. Not only defect functionality, already existing functionalities or tested functionalities, once again we will do testing. So that's why that is called regression testing situation one. Compulsor, we need to test. Okay, all right. Next scenario two. I'm taking 10 in the place of value 1. I'm taking 20 in the place of value 2. I'm clicking on add button, it is working fine. I'm clicking on sub button, it is working fine. I'm clicking on mul button, it is working fine. I'm clicking on div button, it is working fine. I'm clicking on clear button, it is working fine. All buttons are working fine. Next day, they added one more button to that application. That is OK button. Now, can we test the only OK button or all the functionalities?
Again, we need to check all the functionality.
Why already add button, sub button, mul button, div button, clear button, already tested functionalities. Once already tested. Why we need to do once again?
They add the new button. It will affect may or may not the older ones. So we need to check it once again.
Adding the new functionality, whenever incorporating the new functionality, other functionalities may be reflected. Not only new functionality, already tested functionalities also. Once again we will do testing, so that's why that is called regression testing scenario two. Only these two scenarios we will do regression testing once again. So this is the regression testing. Already tested functionalities, again and again we will do testing, so that's why that is called regression testing. This regression testing we will do in two scenarios. First scenario already we discussed, second scenario this one. Whenever incorporating the new functionality to application, already existing functionalities may be reflect or affect. So that's the reason already tested functionalities, once again we will do testing, that's why that is called regression testing situation two. Right. Next, thought testing, retesting. Thought testing, retesting. Thought testing, retesting. Retesting. What is retesting? Already tested functionalities, again and again, we will take with multiple sets of data if you do testing. So that's why that is called retesting. Not only single set of data, we will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. So that's why that is called regression testing. Already tested functionality, again and again we will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. So that's why that is called retesting. Sir, are you there?
Yes sir, yes sir.
Okay. Already tested functionality, again and again we will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. So that's why that is called retesting. For example, I'm taking 10 in the place of value 1, I'm taking 20 in the place of value 2. I'm clicking on add button. It is showing 30. Now can I say add button is properly working?
Yeah.
No, I can't say. I'm taking 10 in the place of value 1, I'm taking 20 in the place of value 2, I'm clicking on add button, it is showing 30. Can I say confidently yes, it is working?
Okay, because this is the one scenario, we need to take another scenario and we need to confirm it once again.
Yes, if I take 10 and 20, this set of data, it is working fine. If I take another set of values, it may work or not, I don't know. So I can't say confidently. So now I will take, so if I take 10 in the place of value 1, if I take 20 in the place of value 2, if I click on add button, it is showing 30. But I can't say confidently, it is working. So then I will take multiple sets of data. I'm taking 100 here, I'm taking 200 here, I'm clicking on add button, it's showing 300. Yes, working. I'm taking 1000 here, I'm taking 2000 here, I'm clicking on add button, it is working fine. No? I'm taking 10,000 here, I'm taking 20,000 here, I'm clicking on add button, it is showing 30,000. Yes, confidently now I can say, yes, it is working. So if you take only single set of value, we can't say confidently. So compulsory we should take some different sets of values. With different sets of values, if it is working, then only we can say that a button is properly working. This type of testing is known as retesting. Already tested functionality. Add functionality, I tested with 10 and 20. So already tested functionality. Again and again. We will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. So that's why that is called retesting. Same functionality. Every time we are taking multiple sets of data and we are testing the same functionality again and again. So this type of testing is known as retesting. Already tested functionality. Again and again, we will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. So that's why that is called retesting. Not only single functionality, already tested functionalities. Again and again. 7 o'clock class leda. Evaru mari abbai ki inform chesaratta. Great. Already tested functionality. Again and again we will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. That's why that is called retesting. Already tested functionality, again and again we will take with multiple sets of data and we will do testing. So that's why that is called retesting. So I'm taking
retesting
means tested functionality. Add functionality already tested with 10 and 20. Not only 10 and 20, I'm taking with multiple sets of data like 100, 200, 1000, 2000, 10,000, 20,000. I'm taking with multiple sets of data. Already tested functionality. Again and again, we will test with multiple sets of data. So that type of testing is known as retesting. These three types of testing is very, very important testing. Whenever you are working with any software company, regularly we will perform. Right. Next testing, alpha testing and beta testing. Yesterday we discussed it. Alpha testing and beta testing. What is alpha testing? What is beta testing? What is alpha testing?
In our company premises, we are doing the testing is the alpha testing. If you are some third party testing, testing is done by the third party at client place, that is called beta.
alpha testing, beta testing, both are user acceptance testings. Presence of the user we will do. Presence of the user we will do. Alpha testing
presence of the user we will do.
Both are alpha testing, beta testing, both are user acceptance testing. So presence of the user we will do testing. Alpha testing means in our company if they do in our people, so that is called alpha testing. So alpha testing advantages, if at all any defect found, then there is a chance of rectifying immediately. Beta testing, this is done by third party people. They are doing in third party location, not in our location, not in customer location. We are doing in other location, so that is called beta testing. What are the advantages of alpha testing? If at all any defect found, then there is a chance of rectifying immediately. That is alpha testing. If at all any defect found, then there is a chance of rectifying immediately. That is the alpha testing advantages. Beta testing and disadvantages is, if while doing testing, if they get any defects, once again they need to send to our company only. There is no chance to rectify the problem. So there is no developers, only testers will be there. If they get any problem, if they get any defect, once again they need to send to our company only. So that is beta testing. So while doing beta testing, if they get any defects, there is no chance to rectifying immediately. That is a bad name for the company. That is the reason all the companies nowadays, they are encouraging only alpha testing, not beta testing. Okay?
Okay.
Next testing, static testing. Next testing, static testing. Static testing. Static testing means without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So that type of testing is known as static testing. Without performing any actions on the application, can we test the application? Is it right? Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So that type of testing is known as static testing. So static testing means without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So that type of testing is known as static testing. Without performing any actions on the application, can we test the application? Is it right? Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So that type of testing is known as static testing. Without performing any actions on the application, can we test the application?
I think no.
No. But okay, static testing without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. For example, customer want one application. In that application, you want three buttons. You want three buttons. A, B, C. So all the buttons are available or not. All the buttons are available or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. So availability based.
Okay.
So without performing any actions, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. One is availability. So if you want to perform static testing, we have five guidelines. One is availability. All the buttons available or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. Next, alignment. Alignment is good or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can say and we can see and say. Consistency. All the buttons are consistent with each other. No need to perform any action. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. And the color. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. Spelling. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. So in these five cases, we can perform static testing. Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. If you want to perform static testing, there are five guidelines. One is availability based, alignment based, consistency based, and color and spelling So these five bases, we can test the application without performing any actions on the application. We can see and say, best example, code review. Code review. Code is properly or not. No need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. And document review. You wrote one document, so I want to check you wrote right or not. So no need to perform any actions. Without performing any actions, we can see and say. So the type of testing is known as static testing. Without performing any actions on the application, we can test the application. So the type of testing is known as static testing. If you want to perform static testing, we have five guidelines: availability, alignment, base consistency, base color, and spelling. Next testing, dynamic testing. Next testing, dynamic testing. Dynamic testing means compulsory we need to perform some actions on the application. There only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. That type of testing is known as dynamic testing. So for example, we have value 1 and value 2 result. So if it is the add button is properly working or not, so compulsory we should take some value into value 1, we should take some value 2 in the value 2, and if you click on add button, so if it is working or not, we can find out. Without taking any values into any field, so we can't find out. So compulsory we should take some actions on the application, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. Dynamic testing means compulsory we need to perform some actions on the functionality, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. Dynamic testing means that is functional testing. Example, functional testing. Compulsory we need to perform some actions on the functionality, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. The type of testing is known as dynamic testing. Compulsory we should perform some actions on the application, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. For example, here I want to test add button is properly working or not. First of all, what happened? Kundavalli Murthy, what happened, Murthy? Hi, Andy Akhil garu. Today I am unable to attend the class, Andy. Team outing for dinner, Andy. No need to stop class for me. Oh God. Just send the recorded file. I can follow up, Andy. Okay. This is madam. కొండవల్లి మూర్తి ఎన్నో ఎన్ని గంటల క్లాస్ అయినది? 8కి. 7 o'clock వాళ్ళు రాన 7 o'clock వాళ్ళు రానన్నారు. 8 o'clock వాళ్ళు ఈయన ఒక ఆయన డుమ్మ. ఇప్పుడు ఎవరున్నారు ఇంకా 8 o'clock వాళ్ళు? ప్రమీల మేడం, రైట్. సారీ సారీ సార్, సారీ ఈయన డిస్టర్బ్ చేస్తుంటే చూశాను. సో ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ యాడ్ బటన్ ఈస్ ప్రాపర్లీ వర్కింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్, ఐ వాంట్ టు చెక్. సో కంపల్సరీ ఐ షుడ్ టేక్ సమ్ వాల్యూస్, value 1 and value 2, and if I click add button, if it is showing 30, then we can say yes, add button is properly working. So that means add button is properly working or not. How we know? Without performing any actions, we can't say. Compulsory we should take some values into value 1 and value 2. If we click on add button, if it is showing 30 or not, compulsory we need to take some values into value 1, value 2, and if we click on add button, 30 is coming or not. So this type of testing is known as functional testing or dynamic testing. So functional testing, best example, QTP and Selenium. These are the functional tools. Compulsory we need to perform some actions on the functionality, then only we can say that functionality is properly working or not. This type of testing is known as dynamic testing. Okay, 7 over. 8th one, installation testing. Installation testing. 8th one, installation testing. Installation testing means after developing the application, after testing the application, we need to go to customer place and we need to install the application into client environment. So this is our task only. After developing the application, after testing the application, we need to go to customer place and we need to install the application into client environment. So if at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. Why? Because each and every software company for installation purpose, they will provide one document, installation document. Using that installation document, we will install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. We will not apply our own ideas. Whatever they given that guidelines, we will follow strictly and we will install the application into client environment. So this type of testing is known as installation testing. Some companies separately, they will maintain deployment engineers. All the companies, they will not maintain deployment engineers. Why? Because deployment will not happen daily regularly. So some companies, they will deliver the application 2 years, 1 year, 1.5 year. So only one day purpose, they will not maintain deployment engineers. So that's the reason senior software test engineer only will go to customer place and they will install the application into client environment. For that purpose, each and every software company, they will maintain, they will give installation document. Using that installation document, we will install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. So that is called installation testing. So installation testing also done by test engineers only, but some company, they will maintain deployment engineers. Very rare. Why? Because deployment will not happen daily, or delivery will happen, will not happen daily. So monthly, also monthly, not monthly, 6 monthly, 6 months once, or 1 year ki, like 1.5 year ki, 2 years ki, 3 years ki, 4 years ki, ok application delivery chestaru. So only one day purpose, they will not maintain deployment engineers. Only senior software test engineers only will go to customer place and they will install the application into client environment. For that purpose, each and every software company, they will maintain deployment document or installation document. Using that installation document, we will install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. That is installation testing. This is also our duty only. Next, compatibility testing, very important testing. Compatibility testing. Compatibility means, so for example, I will tell you with example. ICICI Bank people want one project. ICICI people want one software. So they will say, they said already the developed project should work in Windows 7. So if it is satisfying the Windows 7, so they will choose some technologies, Java or .NET. .NET or PHP, which technology suits for Windows 7? They will choose the technology, so they will develop the application. So that is enough. So only customer, ICICI people want one project. They want that developed project should work in Windows 7. So which technology suits for Windows 7? We will choose that technology and we will develop that application. So they will choose the technology, which technology, Java or .NET or PHP. So they will choose the technology and they will develop the application. They will install the application into client environment. That is project. This is project. Next, Microsoft people, MS means Microsoft. Microsoft people, they want to introduce one software into market. That is X. First, they will install into Windows XP. Windows XP it is working or not. After that, they will install Windows 7. In the Windows 7, it is working or not. Next, Windows 8. They will install in Windows 8. In the Windows 8, it is working or not. Next, Mac or Windows 10. In the Windows 10, it is working or not. Next, they will install in Mac. it is working or not. So already Windows XP already having .NET. So in that situation, it is working or not. Or Windows 7 already having Oracle. In that situation, it is working or not. Windows 8 already having SAP. In that situation, it is working or not. Windows 10 already having Java. It is working or not. Mac already they installed C++. In that situation, it is working or not. They will test with different possible combinations. They will test with different possible combinations. So then only if it is working, then only they will install into, they will deliver into market. So that is called product. So this first one is project. Next one is product. This is the product means worldwide people will access. So for example, we have one product, Skype or MS Office. So these are the products. So worldwide people, they will install in different operating systems. Already they have some softwares. In that situation also, it is working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called compatibility testing. So if it is project, if you satisfy the single customer requirement more than enough. If it is product to worldwide users, they will use in different operating systems. In that situation, it is working or not. Not only different operating systems, already they installed some softwares. In that situation also, it is working or not, we will do testing. So that type of testing is known as compatibility testing. This compatibility testing max we can do in product based companies. Only if it is project, if you satisfy the single customer requirement more than enough. If it is product, worldwide users, so they will use in different operating systems with different softwares, all if they are already installed. In that situation, it is working or not, we will do testing. So that's why that is called compatibility testing. Before going to delivery, so compulsory we need to create different operating systems with different possible combinations. So within that situation, if it is working, then only we will deliver the application to market. So in my system, Skype is not working. Nobody will say. In my systems, TeamViewer is not working. Nobody will say. Why? Because that are the products. So product means first of all they will check with possible combinations. So if it is working with different possible combinations, then only they will deliver into market. So that is product based companies. Product means all operating systems, not only single operating system. If it is satisfied in all the operating system, then only they will deliver into market. So if it is project, if you satisfy the only single customer requirement more than enough. If it is product, so we need to satisfy all the customer requirement, not only Hyderabad people, Bangalore people, UK people, USA people, Australia people, Germany people, Japan people, China people, UK people, they will use that software with the different operating systems. So in that situation, it is allowing or not, it is working or not. So we will do testing. So that's why that is called compatibility testing. These are the 9 types of testings. These are the 9 types of testings already finished. So actually, whenever you are working with any software company, maximum we can perform 18 types of testing, but we discussed only 9 types of testing. Actually, next batch, all thing already ready. Navata sir, 1 week low I will pay you. Deepa made a not yet come. Wait. At any cost, compulsory I should. Okay, these are the 9 types of testing, sir. So 9 on yesterday file, recorded file, I have sent you.